unintended kiss on the second red, though. So it puts a little bit of pressure on this blue, which I'm certain he's going to take on. Didn't want the kiss on the second red. Well, he's looking at the black, but can he reach it? Blue looks the ball.
Yeah, if he screws the blue in and just gets the white anywhere near the line there, he's got the red to the left corner, so needs a good shot, though. Yeah, well played. Very confidently struck.
Six. Seven.
Not the best. He's okay, but he's got to go in and out of the bulk area, avoid the brown and green. You could see him hitting that on the right-hand side and watch the white, how it spins off. Nicely played.
12.
Neil just having a look at the main bunch of reds. Actually, on this red, can play for the black or the pink. Just looking for the red after the colour. I don't think he's on this red where he could play low on the black, which he'd like to play a little cannon. So just studying the options. This is where you do look two or three shots in advance. So is it 21. Pink and just nudge your red, or is he quite happy that he can find a red off the black? He must be.
28.
Must be that red immediately below 28. The pink. It didn't look as though it went. Oh, yes, clearly goes. And nicely on it. Well played.
29. Delightful little cannon there. And that's really opened 36. Things up, and every chance for Neil to come right back at Mark Selby. I made that fabulous century break in the opening frame, but this is how this match has gone. If one puts in a good frame, the other responds.
A little bit trickier. I'm going to use the spider. Nicely played. Never the easiest implement to play with.
You know, 37.
A slight angle on this black. He looks pretty straight. Might just be able to force it round. He's got a red to the right middle. This would be the perfect 44. Reply for Neil after what Mark did to him in the first frame. I just thought there was a few signs, 45. Dennis, in the middle of the second session that big breaks weren't winning it. Neither player were winning the frames in one visit, and it just needed someone to just raise his game. Looked like Mark Selby has raised his game, but perfect reply this.
50.
From Neil Robertson. He saw the warning signs, had to try and impose himself now in this session, and every chance he'll do it at this visit. So there's all the 51. Potential of being an absolute classic.
Just needs one more red to make absolutely sure of taking the second frame. Just a quick glance at the scoreboard there.
59. Very well played, Neil Robertson. Mark Selby put a marker down and he's responded. So what a start to this third session. Wouldn't it be nice and good for his confidence, Neil, if 64. He could make a century? A little bit awkward with a couple of reds near the side cushion.
65.
Well, they've both made two centuries now in this semi-final. And we're starting to see two players at the top of their form. And what better place to play your best snooker than the Crucible Theatre.
70.
Yeah, this is the last of the easy reds.
71.
A nice angle on this black now to nudge that red on the left-hand side of the table. If he catches it just less than half ball, he could develop it for the middle. Well, he's played it a bit pacier than that. He needs to slow up to be able to pass the blue, and it's OK.
78.
So this is one problem ball in the open. Oh, it went in. Not three
79.
Times, but knew the password.
And being a left-hander, the red's the wrong side of the table for Neil. Rob Walker introduces Neil Robertson. He's now added the centurion because of that.
84.
Century of centuries in one season. He's made 102 now. What a marker he's set down.
85.
Wonderful shot. Okay. He didn't try to get the cue ball away from the cushion. He knew this black would be difficult. 80. Oh, and in the end, it turned out to be just a little bit too difficult. But he'll be very pleased to respond to that 100 break by Mark Selby in the first frame of this session. He's come right back. Marvellous 85. He still trails, though, by two. Selby, 10. Robertson, 8.